Hi, Bob.
Hi, Wendy. The drive-through window is all ready now. I just need you to install the inside intercom, please.
No problem. But how about a break first? Chef Tatty said we could help ourselves to a milkshake.
That's cool. I've always wanted to create my own milkshake. Now, what should I put in? Two bananas, a sprinkling of raisins, loads of peanut butter, ooh, a squeeze of lemon, ooh, and a spoon of wobbly jelly.
Really? All those ingredients together?
Just you wait, Wendy. This milkshake is going to be smooth and delicious. Wait! I forgot the ice cream and milk. Now it looks smooth and delicious.
Smooth? Yes.
Oh, but not that delicious.
Paint dry? Check. Arrows are on? Check. So, the next thing to film is the building of the curb that will separate the car park from the drive-thru.
Hey, Leo! You should film me breaking up the ground to make the new curb! It'll be great!
Thanks, Scoop, but I haven't filmed Muck yet.
You want to film me? Are you sure?
Just tell the camera how you clear away dirt.
Don't worry, Muck, I've got this. As you can see, breaking up the ground makes a lot of mess. So we have to clean up after ourselves.
Scoop! You're gonna hit the...
Oops!
Oh, intercom unit.
Uh-oh.
Oh, don't worry. It's just a little bump. It'll be fine.
Ah! Oh, no.
Oh!
Oh, I'm clearing, dirt.
And I'm pouring cement. Then we'll put large stones on top of it to make the new curb.
Oh, but I'm the one with the talent and good looks.
There. The intercom is ready.
Great. And now it's time for a milkshake.
You're not going to make another one.
Don't worry, Wendy. This time I'm going to make a simple strawberry milkshake. What could go wrong? Oh, oh, uh-oh.
Come on, Daisy. You can calm down. I'll count again, but this time I will get past three. One, two, three, four.
Right, that's the heating on. How are you getting on with the poopy, Jenny?
Just finished, Wendy. Oh, no.
What?
I think I've just glued myself to this post by mistake.
Really?
Don't worry, Jenny. There you go. You'd caught your sleeve, that's all.
Thanks, Bob.
Oh, Dizzy will want to see the poopy, won't she?
Oh, yes. I'll go and find her.
17, 18, 19. Ooh, hi, Wendy.
Hi, Dizzy. Dizzy, don't move or say a thing. Understand?
No.
Well, just really, really quietly say okay, okay?
Okay.
A butterfly has landed on your mixing drum.
Oh, that's so...
Shh! Stay still. If it flies off, we may never see it again.
Oh, Bob, they're starting to hatch.
Already? Then we got them in here just in time.
I'll go and get Wendy and Dizzy. They won't want to miss this.
Jenny, thank goodness. Look.
That's a Menelaus blue morpho. It's one of my butterflies. How did it...
It hatched in Dizzy's drum. Can you catch it and get it inside?
I don't have a net. And anyway, it could fly away any moment. Dizzy, It's up to you to save my butterfly. Can you drive very slowly and carefully back inside?
I'll try, but what if I'm too noisy and scary?
Dizzy, we can't hear a word you're saying.
I said, what if I'm too noisy and scary?
We'll just have to hope it doesn't fly off.
I really believe you can do this, Dizzy.
Me too. Just pretend the butterfly isn't there.
Okay.
Come on, Dizzy. Slow and steady.
You can do it, Dizzy.
This is absolutely amazing.
Hello, Muck.
Hello,
hiya.
Muck.
Hiya.
We're off to the sports stadium. Sky's got a big surprise for us.
Oh, that's exciting.
I'm looking for Two-Ton, but I can't find him anywhere. Have you seen him?
We passed him at the town hall not long ago. It looked like he was dropping off a big delivery.
Thank you so much, Betsy. See ya.
Oh.
Mind how you go.
Oh, dear me, no.
Hello, Mr. Bentley. I'm looking for Dash Lightning's movie props. Are they in that container, please?
Eh? No. Just dozens of old statues packed in crates of straw.
Oh! Thank you, Mr. Bentley. Bye.
I was expecting new furniture for the town hall. A sofa for the mayor's office. Some lovely, colourful cushions.
I'm never gonna find Two-Ton in time. Now I'll have to tell Bob the bad news.
It's looking great. We're getting there, Wendy.
But we still need to install those props, Bob. And soon.
Ah, there you are, Muck. Any luck?
Oh, Bob, I'm so sorry. I've been looking everywhere, but I still can't find Two-Ton.
But without that container of props, we can't finish the ride.
I did see one container at the museum and another at the town hall, but they didn't have our props.
Ah, but what was inside them, Muck?
Let's see. Mr. Bentley had statues, but he wanted sofas. Anish had footballs and sporty stuff, but he wanted statues.
Well, we've got Mr. Bentley's sofas.
That's right, Leo. So, where would all the sporty stuff need to go?
The sports stadium!
Oh! Betsy and the Spring City Rockets were going to the sports stadium. Safi said something about a big surprise.
That could be it. A surprise container of sports equipment. Come on, Muck. Let's go and find out.
Well, this is a surprise, Two-Ton. Just not quite the one I was expecting.
No, that shouldn't happen.
Ah, hi, guys.
Hi, Sky. You've probably guessed there's been a big mix-up. Your sports equipment is at the museum.
How did I make such a mistake, Bob?
It's my fault, Two-Ton. I picked out the wrong container at Roland's.
So, now we know where everything's meant to be. These movie props go to the film studio, the furniture to the town hall, the statues to the museum, and the sports equipment comes here.
Got it, Bob. Now let's pack up that shark and get rolling.
It's manure, Sky. It makes the flowers and, it doesn't matter. I'll just go.
Oh!
It's at the back of my eyes.
Oh, no. It's the Spring City Rockets. I don't want them to smell me as well. I think I'll go the long way around. Maybe if I go fast enough, no one will notice the stinky smell.
Yeah. Huh?
Gross.
Thanks, Lofty. There we are. That's out of sight, isn't it?
No, I can still see it.
What if we put it right next to the shed? You'll hardly see it at all there.
But I'll still be able to see it a bit.
Don't worry, Mayor Madison. I'm sure we'll find just the right place for it. Up we go again, Lofty.
I think closer. Here?
No. Further away.
Okay, as long as you're sure. Oh, no. No.
No.
It'll be over there.
Huh? What?
I think further away.
Oh, no. Closer.
Further away.
Closer.
Oh. Nearly there. Oh, no. It's Philip. I don't want him to think that I'm stinky. Don't worry, Mum.
Slow down, Muck.
Be careful, Muck.
Muck, what on earth is going on?
I'm sorry, Bob. I didn't like it when people thought I was smelly. So I went a really long way round so people couldn't smell me. And then I got late and in a real rush and then I...
It's all right, Muck. It's all right. And you're not smelly. It's just the manure.
Yes, Muck. And we'll give you a good wash when you get back to the yard.
Oh, really?
Yes. And after that, you'll smell as fresh as one of Mayor Madison's roses.
Oh, well, no turnips for me.
Oh, at least the beds for my flowers are still all right.
Who wants to share a garage anyway, Lofty? I mean, I'd rather be on my own, really, instead of having someone get in my way all the time.
That's not what you were saying before, Dizzy. Before, you were saying how much fun it would be.
Well, it won't be now, will it? Because Shift has spoilt everything.
I don't think that's fair, Dizzy.
Thanks, Lofty.
It's not that Shifter doesn't want to share it with you.
Huh?
He's just upset because he thought he was getting his own garage.
Oh. And it was me that got his hopes up in the first place, wasn't it? Oh, you're right, Lofty. This isn't Shifter's fault at all.
Dizzy, did Shifter bring over that new box of bolts? I need it now.
Yes, he did, Bob. But he's still carrying it round with him.
Right. I'll have to go and get it. Hi, Wendy. Is Shifter okay?
Oh, I'm afraid not. He's hiding in the gravel store. He won't talk and he won't come out.
We'll have to try and put this right somehow. And then we need to get the garages finished.
Bob, could I try talking to Shifter again? I wasn't very kind to him just now and I really would like to share with him.
Thank you, Dizzy. That's very sweet of you.
Yes, it really is. Bob and I should have explained everything to Shifter before we started. But I'm sure you're the best one to talk to him.
Come on, then. Let's see what we can do.
I'm sorry I was cross-shifter.
Go away, please, Dizzy. I don't want to talk to anyone right now.
I didn't mean what I said about not wanting to share with you. I really do want to share. And I love the idea of one red wall and one that's green with orange round it.
You mean like I want for my garage?
Yes! And I've got a brilliant butterfly poster up, but there's room for another, so we could have a Dash Lightning poster too.
Like Mock's.
Yes! Dash Lightning's so amazing. We can play Dash Lightning games. What does he say? Zoom! Boom!
Lightning strikes twice. I know lots of Dash Lightning games.
Will you teach them to me?
Okay. Bob, can you and Wendy paint Dizzy's garage today?
We certainly can, Shifter. Just as soon as you've given me those bolts.
Oops.
And we finished building the new garages.
Yay! Let's do it!
Look up there! It's like the snow's made a kind of cliff. That looks really cool!
Oh, yeah, it does. Anyway, it's time I got back to Wendy.
No, wait, hold on, Trent! Watch me first! I want to do a spin like the one you just did.
Still think you can be king of the road, do you? Off you go, then. Surprise me.
I will! Watch this! Here comes a really mega super skate!
Oh, was that it?
No! Stay there, Tread. That was just a practice. Right, here comes the real thing.
Go on, then. Last chance.
Oh, no! Get out of the way, Tread! 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 Can you hear me?
I'm over here, Scoop.
Oh, thank goodness. Are you okay?
Well, kind of.
Oh, dear. But I can't move. I'm completely stuck.
Hold on. I'll dig you out. I'm sorry, Tread. There's loads of snow. This is going to take ages.
But you won't be able to get all the way over here without snow chains anyway, Scoop. Find Wendy. She'll know what to do.
Yes. OK. Good idea. I won't be long.
Quick as you can, though, eh? It's really cold in here.
Wendy! Wendy! Help!
What is it?
Wendy, there's been an avalanche.
An avalanche? Where? And where's Tread?
Tread's been buried down this hill. The avalanche just came whooshing down and buried him. And I couldn't dig him out because I haven't got snow chains. And...
It's all right, Scoob. It's all right. Don't worry. You did the right thing not to try. We don't want you getting stuck too.
Hi, Wendy.
Hi, Bob. We've got an emergency on Observatory Hill. We need to stretch here as quickly as possible.
We're on our way.
Poor Tread, I hope he's all right.
Wendy says he's very cold and very stuck, but not hurt.
Oh, well, that's good.
With your track stretch, you should be able to get across the snow and dig him out.
Oh, I'll do my best, Bob.
Could you hurry up, please? I'm a bit, Is it over there?
Oh, yeah, I know. Here we are.
Oh, come on, come on, come on.
There you go.
Cheers, Leo.
No worries.
Huh? Right.
Oh, not the phone again. Don't answer it. Don't answer it.
Hi, Chef Tutty.
Oh.
Is everything okay?
I'm not sure, Bob. Do you have any idea where Tread is?
Yes, he's here with me.
Could you ask him to get to the sushi bar as soon as he can, or my fish could go off and be ruined?
I'll tell him right away, Chef. Bye.
Yeah, okay, great, Bob. Bye. I've got to roll.
No, wait, Tread. Come back. Chef Tatty's waiting for you at the sushi bar. He said something about some fish going off.
I know, the fish. Gotta go, Bob.
No.
Ah, Tread! There you are.
Sorry I'm late, Chef Tatty.
No worries. Well, actually, I was starting to get a wee bit worried about my fish. It doesn't smell off. In fact, it doesn't smell at all. Huh? What are these?
What's wrong now?
Tiles?
Oh, dear. If you've got the tiles, then what has Bob got?
Huh? Uh-oh. Hello?
Have you got a box there with my fish in it, Bob?
No, I've just opened it, and I appear to have a control panel.
So who's got my fish?
Oh, no.
Huh? Hello?
Hi, Wendy. It's Chef Tatty. Are you by any chance staring at a fish? What on earth's going on?
Sir Bob, you've got the control panel and Chef Tatty has the tiles.
And Wendy has the fish, which will be spoiled soon if it isn't refrigerated.
And someone still needs to pick up Leo in the cupboard and drop them off at the sushi bar.
I'm sorry, Bob. I should have told you. I was getting too busy.
It's
not your fault, Tread. Wendy and I should have picked up the right boxes.
Well, I still try to do too much, and I wouldn't let anyone help.
Oh. Oh, no! Not more! And I promised to be so careful.
Right, that's the roof finished. Now for the timber cladding.
Oh. Huh? Who's been eating those? Flame? What are you doing here? Oh no, Flame, it's you who's been knocking down the apples. Stop! Flame! Come back! Flame! Come back! Stop!
I've finished clearing out the barn, Bob. What shall I do next? Whoa! Look out!
Will! Stop! Flame! Stop!
Huh?
Whoa! Oh. Are you all right, Leo?
I'm okay, Muck. But I'd better make sure Flame stays on her side of the fence from now on.
Oh, no! There are apples everywhere, and it's all my fault.
Why is it your fault, Muck?
Because I chased Flame. Because she was eating apples. Because I broke her fence. Because...
Because?
Because... I'll show you. I thought I'd knock down all the apples, and I didn't want to upset Chef Tatty, so I put them here.
Oh, Muck, it was Flame. Once she got into the orchard, she knocked down most of them.
But if you'd told us, instead of hiding the apples, we might have realised it was Flame's fault sooner.
Then I'm not going to hide things anymore. I'll give these to Chef Tatty.
I'm not sure he'll be able to use those, Muck.
Oh, but I still want to show him.
Well, he'll arrive soon, so we need to fix the damage to the barn.
Oh, no! Oh, no! Ow!
Oh!
Get off! Get off! I can't shake it loose!
What's happening down there?
Bob? I accidentally hit the power box in the maintenance garage, and now all the garage doors have closed and Scoop and Muck are trapped.
Trapped?
And now I've broken the scaffold tower, so you're stuck on the roof too.
I can reach you.
It's too dangerous with that bit of scaffold jammed on your hook, Lofty.
Oops.
Oh, I don't know what I did to make such a mess.
Maybe you were working a little too fast without taking enough care, Shifter.
Well, we need to think fast about how to get down from up here.
We could use a ladder. But those are all stuck in the garages too.
Could we build a ladder? Or a staircase or something?
That's not a bad idea, Shifter. Perhaps you could use some of those empty pallets you cleared away.
Yes, I could do that. But I'll need help.
I can't help you, Shifter.
Oh, no. Oh, but I know someone who can. Tread, it's an emergency. I need your help to move the pallets back to the yard again. Come on!
I'd love to, Shifter. I really would, but there's one problem. I'm surrounded.
Oh, yes, I see. Sorry. Here.
Right, young Shifter, here I am. Start loading me up.
That's the idea, Shifter.
Not so fast, Shifter. Take it easy.
Okay, Tread. Now I'll move yours. It's working! Back in the boat, Bob! We'll have you down in no time! That's it, Bob! I've used all of the pallets!
Thanks, Shifter. Let's go, Wendy.
Ooh, do be careful, both of you!
We're almost there, but we need two more steps to get down.
Yes! I know what to do!
Oh, I get it!
Where are you going?
Push the blade of your bucket underneath, Matt.
Like this?
Yes, that's right. As far as you can. Okay, are you ready to lift?
Yes, I think so.
Right, on three. Three, lift! Yes! Now we have to move it. I'll come forward, you reverse, okay?
Okay. Take it slowly, Scoop. Ready?
Now! Yay! Look, we're moving it!
Well done, you two!
Yes, you worked together really well there because you listened to each other.
I bet Shifter could lift that stone up really easily.
I don't think so, Scoop. It's very heavy.
Where is Shifter? He seems to have disappeared.
Huh? It's not like Shifter to go off on his own. He doesn't know his way around Spring City. We'd better go and find him. Wendy, Stretch, please would you stay here in case he comes back?
Okay, Bob.
Will do.
The rest of us will search the city. Right, team? Can we find him?
Yes, we can!
Everywhere.
Where else can he be?
Help! Oh, help me, someone! Can anyone hear me?
Hold on. Did you hear that?
Hello?
Huh?
Shifter here. I'm stuck.
He's behind that hill. Quick,
can
let's go!
Help me! Oi! Please help!
We're here, Shifter! Shifter, what happened?
Are you trying to be a digger or something?
It's not funny, Scoop. I'm really stuck. Can you help me get the right way up?
Why don't you pull your forks out?
Because I can only move them up and down. I'm going to do that. This happens.
Oh, I can't control it, Bob. Wow!
Oh! Oh, no!
I can't hold it. Scoop, that was your big moment.
Well done.
My camera drone! Oh, no!
Did you get any of that?
Oh, no.
I am so sorry. I've ruined everything.
Don't worry, Lofty. We can get a replacement panel for the fence from the yard.
And this section of the gateway's cracked just here. We'll need to replace it.
Okay. Scoop and I can pick up a new one of those too.
My drone is broken, but the camera's okay, thank goodness.
Hooray! The camera still works!
Why did you lift with such a long hoist in this wind, Lofty?
I was trying to get away from the drone. I don't like being filmed. I'm just a bit shy, I suppose.
I'm sorry, Lofty. I'll keep you out of shot from now on. And Bob, I won't need you to do any more talking.
Really?
I'm afraid so. You're, not really a natural on camera.
Phew! That's a relief.
What?
The truth is, Lofty, I don't like being on camera either. Especially talking on camera.
Well, hey, I'm not the only one!
So, who is going to be on camera explaining what's going on? Eh?
Actually, Scoop, I think I know who'd make a great replacement.
At last! I am ready for my big mob.
Huh? What do you think, Wendy?
Can I film you?
Yes, you can!
Yes, you can.
Right, team. Today we're going to be building an exercise trail.
We'll be building five places where people can stop and do Keep Fit exercises at different areas around this park.
So, we're going to start...
Huh? Hi, Sky.
Hiya, team Bob. Everyone revved up and ready to build the exercise trail?
Yes!
That's the sporting spirit.
But how will people know what exercises to do, Sky?
Well, signs like this will show people what to do. See? This shows someone walking along a balance beam like this one.
Ah!
But why are we building them in different places and not all together in the same place?
So people can run from one exercise to the next, Dizzy.
It really gets you puffing and panting and your muscles working.
Wow! And people can do all this?
Of course!
People can do anything if they try. You should always push yourself to the limits and never be scared to try something new.
Wow. I would love to try something new. Do something I've never done before.
Anyway, I'm running to Riverdale and back today. And after that, I can try out the exercise trail. I can't wait. See you later.
Right, team, you heard Skye. She'll be back later and we've got an exercise trail to build.
And I have to find something to do that I've never done before.
Can we build it?
Yes, we can!
I've drilled all the holes at the other sites, ready for the rest of the build, Bob.
Great. Thanks, Scoop. Have you finished that chin-up bar, Leo?
Yes, Bob. I'm just going to give it a quick test.
Go, Leo!
That's the sporting spirit. Right. So... we've got the press-ups and the monkey bars to do next.
And then we'll finish off with the parallel bars.
Scoop, as you finish the holes, Leo can help you put your rear bucket back on now.
Will do.
No problem, Bob.
Oh, no! Uh-oh. No, the hoops. Now what have I done?
Roley, what's going on?
I've crashed into the dugout and I've ruined the basketball hoops.
It's not like you to make a mistake, Roley. What happened?
I was too busy thinking about my speech and all the people who will be coming.
Don't worry, Roley. We can fix the dugout.
And we can replace the poles for these hoops.
But Betsy's here with the rockets and other people will start turning up soon. They'll see what a mess I've made.
Betsy hasn't picked the rockets up from swimming yet. She just came to say she'd like to hear your speech too.
Oh, no. Not another one. I'll never be able to relax with all those people and machines watching me.
They might be watching you, Roley, but you don't have to watch them.
But what if I forget what building we've done? I'll feel really silly.
You won't forget because Bob can remind you.
Can I?
How?
Bob can give you hand signals to remind you about everything we've done. Raking, rolling, and line painting. See?
That's a great idea, Wendy.
It certainly is. Now, can we fix it?
Yes, we can!
After all the gravel was packed down, we moved on to stage four, the asphalt. Which Bob and Wendy spread out using rakes. And I, rolled nice and flat, like this. In stage five, Bob and Wendy painted the lines which mark out the court. Then, finally, they put up two new basketball hoops. And that is the end of my speech.
Well done!
Brilliant!
Well done!
Brilliant, Roley!
That was great! Thanks, Roley!
I really, really, really want to be a builder now.
Thanks, Safi. But I only remembered what to say because Bob was giving me hand signals.
But I only gave you two signals. You did all the rest yourself.
Really? Did I?
Wow!
Can one of you collect them whilst I check things here?
Scoop will do it.
Huh?
Thanks, Scoop.
Sure. I'll go. No problem.
He is so brave.
Really, really brave.
I'm not scared. Tra-la-la, la-la-la-la. I'm thinking happy thoughts about digging in places that aren't scary, like this one. Okay, right. Just one long path to go. So, I'm gonna go. I'm going. Now.
Go!
Hello? Anyone there?
It's a dinosaur! Help! Dinosaurs are the nerds!
It's okay, Scoop. It's just the wind again. There's nothing scary here. There's nothing scary at all.
Scoop! Scoop! What's wrong?
This is the scariest job ever.
Are you all right?
What happened?
This way, Scoop. Slowly does it. Now, tell us what happened.
I saw a dinosaur skeleton, Bob, at the gates. It was staring right at me.
Oh, Scoop, no. You saw the Model T-Rex skeleton, that's all. Two-ton has just delivered it.
Oh, it really scared me. Actually, Bob, I've been scared all day, to be honest. But I didn't want to say anything because I wanted my friends to think I was brave.
Scoop? It's okay to be scared.
I still think you're brave.
Oh, thanks, guys.
Now, do you see? Things are never really scary.
Like the hedgehog and the wind. We just imagined that they were scary.
Exactly. Now, come on. Visitors will be arriving soon, and we've got a boneyard to finish.
Great! Now we just need to fix the crow's nest back on and we're done. Hang on. There's only half of it here. Where has the other half gone?
It was here earlier when I was talking to Scoop about how he's been collecting things.
Scoop? Collecting things? Oh, no. You don't think he could have taken it, do you, Lofty?
I suppose,
Hello, Mr. Bentley.
Ah, hello, Bob. Just to let you know, I'll be along soon to see that lovely ship all fixed up.
Okay. Great.
Bye for now.
Bye, Mr. Bentley. Right. We really do need to find Scoop. And fast.
Bob, we can't find Scoop anywhere, Bob.
Okay, thanks, Leo.
Keep searching. Muck!
Oh, hello, Bob.
Muck, do you know where Scoop is?
I know where he might be.
Scoop!
Huh?
There you are.
Hi, Bob.
Listen, we need that crow's nest.
Crow's nest? What's a crow's nest?
That's a crow's nest. It belongs on the mast of the ship. We need it.
Oh! I thought it was going to be recycled.
It's an important part of the ship, Scoop.
Oh, I didn't know. Maybe I should have checked before I took it.
Well, yes, you should always check. But never mind now. Let's take it back and fix it to the mast. Steady. Hold it there. Perfect.
Oh, hello, Gull. You helped me find that strange ball. I wonder where it came from. Ah, the ball! So that's where it came from! Bob, this mast is missing its ball from the top.
It is? Yes, you're right, Scoop. It is.
I know where it is. I'll go and get it.
Okay, but be quick. Mr. Bentley will be here any moment. Okay. Phew.
Oh, look, they really love it.
So do I. Well done, everyone.
Thanks, Jenny.
Thank you. No prob. Pilchard! How did you get up there?
Oh, you were supposed to be looking after her, Scoop.
I said it was a bad idea.
What's she doing here? Oh, no!
Uh-oh.
It's all my fault, Bob. What happened was
Tell me later, Scoop. Right now, we need to get her out of there.
But how? We can't go in while the bears are there. It's not safe.
Maybe I could lift my bucket over the fence. That way she could climb in. Pilchard! Here you go! Pilchard!
Oh, thanks, Scoop. What does Pilchard like?
I know! Quick, Bob, we need fish!
Brilliant, Scoop.
I just got some ready for the penguin's lunch.
Stop!
Oh,
no!
Oh, look over
please
here!
Please don't hurt Pilchard!
Lower your bucket, Scoop.
Fishy, fishy! Nice fish for you!
Uh-oh! I forgot bears love fish too!
Come on, Pilchard!
Yes!
Oh, you silly cat, Pilchard. I thought that bear was going to hurt you.
Sorry, Bob.
I should have known a building site wasn't a safe place for a pet.
Especially not a site full of wild animals, Scoop. But I'm just so relieved she's safe.
I brought her to work because Safi said she took her dog to school and... Hey! Safi's class is coming to the zoo this afternoon. We need to work extra fast to clear up.
Yes, please. I really need to open the zoo now Pilchard's safe.
Right, let's go, team. Okay, Lofty. You need to extend your boom as far as it will go.
All right. Here we go.
Oh. Yes. This place looks nice and safe.
Oh, a little bit closer, Lofty.
What's that noise?
Not sure. An aeroplane?
Okay, lower your winch now.
Righto, Bob. I can't hold it. Watch out below.
Oh, no.
Lofty, are you all right?
No, Bob. I can't move at all.
What happened?
It was lifting this heavy concrete so high. I think I've broken something.
Oh, Lofty, you should have told us. You're going to need some repairs.
I just wanted to keep up with Tiny. I thought I could do it. But I was wrong. Bob, that's the only exit and now it's blocked. What are we going to do?
Maybe I can reach it. No, sorry, guys. It's too far away.
So how are we going to get out?
Well, if I can get out, Curtis can fix me. And then I'll be able to unblock the entrance. I know I should have accepted your help earlier, Tiny. But maybe you can help me now.
Sure, little guy.
Here I am, Tiny, ready for my extra heavy load. Stand by, Two-Ton. Time for some tower power.
Steady, Tiny. Woo! I'm so high up. Hello down there. Whee! Okay.
Here goes.
How exciting. Yeah!
One crane for delivery to Curtis. Ready to go, Lofty?
Ready to go. Drive on, Two-Ton.
While you're gone, would you like me to put in some sections for you?
Oh, yes, please, Tiny. That would be a big help. That was...
Yellow first. Yellow. Yellow.
Green.
Yellow. Do the yellow one.
Blue.
Yellow. Leo. Leo. Yellow.
Red.
Yellow. Leo.
Green.
Yellow. Yellow.
Blue.
Leo. Yellow.
Red.
Yellow.
Purple.
Yellow. Yellow.
Okay.
Yellow.
Yellow goes here.
Yes!
There, see? I know what I'm doing.
Everything okay, Leo?
Yep. We can test it now, Bob.
Excellent. Would you untie your dad's boat, please? Then I'll see if I can lift it with a hoist.
Okay.
There. Now we can power up.
Let's go, go, go! It's working, Bob!
The boat's ready for lifting, Bob!
Right. Here goes. That's not right. Maybe I need to push it this way. Oops. Right.
Uh-oh.
What?
Look out, Scoop!
Ooh, it's chasing me!
I've got it!
I think.
Oops!
Oh, no!
Ooh, oh, no!
Why is this going the wrong way?
What are you doing, Bob?
I think I'm getting the hang of it now.
Oops!
Ah, I'm getting out of here!
No, stay still, Scoop!
Huh?
Uh-oh.
Oh! Dear. Oh, no!
Oh, 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 I'm flying!
Oh, no!
Whoa!
Who knew? Scoop! Oh, where's the stop button?
Hang on, Scoop! I'll get you down.
Whoa! 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 Oh, no!
Don't drop him, Bob!
I'm trying not to, Lofty.
Bob! Get me down!
Try. I must have got the wires mixed up somehow, but I think I know what to do. Hurry, Leo. It's working backwards, so if I want to move the hoist left, I need to move the joystick right, like this. Yes!
No, too fast!
Under, pull it tight, make a bow, and it's tied right. There, all secured. Ready for the sea trials, Bob?
Not yet, Captain Bentley.
Ah, I do wish they'd hurry up. I can't wait to get out on the open sea.
Huh? What's happening?
Oh, that's not good.
Whoa! The ship!
And Captain Bentley!
I haven't connected the engine yet. He's going to drift out to sea.
Back up, Lofty, quick as you can.
Yes, Bob.
Oh! Oh, no. Oh, no.
Off we go, Lofty. Follow that ship. Mr. Bentley! Drop the anchor!
I don't know how!
I'll stop him, Bob! Oh, messed. I can't reach!
What?
I can't reach!
What?
Oh, double dear. We're heading for the open sea. What do we do, Gull? Oh, no.
Bob, quick, get in! I can catch her up! It's time to find your sea legs! Jump in, landlubber!
It's all a dream, a terrible dream! Help me, Horatio!
Mr. Bentley! Drop the anchor!
Oh, thank goodness for that! A rescue party! Ahoy there!
Steady as she goes!
Here I am, Bob!
Hold on!
Thank goodness you're here, Bob. How do we drop the anchor?
Like this. There. Let's hope it holds on the riverbed.
Whoa. Yeah!
You did it, Bob! Well done.
Not bad for a landlubber.
I'm sorry I interfered with your work. When it comes to building, you're the captain.
Thank you, Mr. Bentley.
I might keep the hat, though. Can we go back now?
Whoa. The sooner the better.
Land ahoy!
Yay!
Right, team. We've got a ship to make ship shape. So, can we fix it?
Yes, we can!
Let's give it a test drive.
Conveyor belt? What's that for?
It's to move the food around the restaurant, Scoop.
Ready, steady. Lunchtime builders. Toot, toot.
Oh, wow, that's so cool!
Fabulous, Chef Tatty. This is my favourite kind of dining.
Last chance for lunch, Bob. Bon appetit.
OK, I'll try this one.
What do you think, Bob?
Tatty-licious! Hey!
Well, Scoop, what do you think of the conveyor belt?
I think it's magical.
I can't believe Sylvan pulled that rabbit out of his head.
Now that's proper magic, that is.
Ha! That's not magic. This is magic. Behold, the colour-changing balls of mystery. Green, red, blue and purple, all sitting on the table. Abracadigga, alakazella. Come on. Make the balls change their colour! Ta-da! Pink, white, yellow, orange.
Wow!
That actually is quite a good trick, Scoop.
Oh, yes!
It's brilliant! Do it again, Scoop.
Yes, go on, Scoop, do it again.
Okay, then. Abracadigga, alakum... Whoa, not so fast. Slow down! Whoa!
No,
stop!
No.
Stop!
No!
Ooh. Ouch! Whoa! No! Mm-hmm. Stop!
Abracadabra!
Oh, Scoop, what have you done?
Oh, I am so sorry. I was just trying to wow Muck and Lofty with a magic trick.
Magic tricks take a lot of practice, Scoop. And preferably not using building materials or lunch.
Oh, this is a disaster. You'll never finish before tonight's audience arrives.
If we work hard, I think we can fix it in time.
So, team, let's get to work.
Later.
Woohoo! Anything I can do to help, Leo?
Bob's put me in charge of building a giraffe house at the zoo.
A giraffe house? Can I help, Leo? Can I?
Oh, of course, Lofty. I expect it will be a really tall building, so I'll need your help. Come on, the sooner we collect up the materials, the sooner we can get started.
Yay!
Okay, so I need 6 pieces of 2x6.
6? That's not very many.
That's what it says on the plan.
And Bob knows best.
Yes, that's right. He does. And 20 pieces of 2x4, 4 cinder blocks, plywood sheeting, brackets, screws, hinges.
No, that's 4x8.
Oops. Sorry.
Too much to carry. We'll get Tred to help us out.
Did somebody mention my name?
Oh!
Hi, guys!
Hi!
This is so exciting! I've seen Bob's plans and they looked brilliant.
Ah, Bob's the best. So, one giraffe house coming up. Can we build it?
Yes, we can!
All right!
All done. This is one tidy office. I think Wendy will be very impressed.
Sorry, Bob, but I am sorting it out.
Yes, it does look a bit messy. It's like I always say, a
workplace needs to be kept tidy.
Oh, is that what you always say, Bob?
Ah, hello, Wendy. I was just, I finished the office. Yay!
I've just seen it. Good job.
Thanks. Told you I'd fix it. Hello, Tread. What's up?
I think you'd better come along to the zoo, Bob. We've got a little problem.
Uh-oh.
Is this where the Christmas party's going to be, Bob? Is it? Is it?
Yes, Lofty. Mr. Bentley said he would meet us here.
Ah, oh, Bob, there you are at last.
Hello, Mr. Bentley.
I think the party centrepiece should go right here, don't you?
Great idea. We'll build the giant sleigh in no time, Mr. Bentley.
Wonderful. I love Christmas Eve. Oh, and of course, there's all the extra bits to do as well.
Did he say extra bits?
Uh-oh.
And so, we need to arrange the snow scene, the tree, and put up all these lights. I ordered hundreds. This will be the best Christmas party Fixham has ever had, all the way along the seafront as far as the galleon.
That's all going to take some time to put up.
But it's Christmas, Wendy.
We'll make sure Fixham gets its Christmas party, Mr. Bentley. And it will be the best ever.
Thank you, Bob.
Okay, team. Let's get to work. Can we build it?
Yes, we can.
Oh, the sleigh looks great, Bob. But what colour will it be?
Well, I was going to paint it red.
Oh, and gold.
Huh?
Yes, can it be red and gold?
Of course. You really do love Christmas, don't you, Mr. Bentley?
Yes, ever since I was a little boy, I've always dreamed of having the best possible Christmas party. Now, we need more snow and more lights.
Wow, Mr. Bentley is so excited.
He is. But then who isn't?
Uh-oh, Mr. Bentley's coming.
Oh, no. Do you think he'll want to change things again?
Oh, Leo!
Ho, 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 Mr. Bentley!
Excellent Christmas spirit, Leo. Now, how about stringing lights from these candy canes right up to the galleon's mast?
We could do that, but we've hung so many already.
Don't worry, we've got plenty more.